Hey everyone, get excited. A new software update is coming soon to the Kia EV6. So today I'm going to go through the process to manually run the update so you don't have to wait for the over-the-air update to be pushed to your vehicle. So Kia does software updates for their radio and navigation systems twice a year in about the April or May timeframe and October or November. They have two main radio system updates at this point. First is what they call the display audio software update for normal radios, and then the navigation map and software update for the radios that have navigation built in, like the Kia EV6. Updates for both radios typically come out within a week of each other, and the latest display audio software update just became available today, which means we should see an update available for the Kia EV6 within the next few days. Now, I know some of you are thinking the Kia EV6 has over-the-air updates. I don't need to do anything manually to update the software, and you're 100% correct. However, over-the-air updates are not instantaneous. They have to be pushed out to everyone's vehicles, which, from what we've seen so far, can take weeks or months to get to everybody. And these updates are huge. The last one was around 31 gigabytes. Since the over-the-air updates use the built-in LTE to download the software update itself, it's typically going to be much faster to download it using your home Wi-Fi and then transfer it to your vehicle. So if you want the update as soon as it's available, the best way is likely going to be to manually update the software yourself, so I'm going to show you how to do that. Before I get to that though, if you find this video helpful, please hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me out. I also have a lot of videos and giveaways coming up that you're not going to want to miss, so make sure you hit that notification bell too. Now for the update, first, to verify an update is actually available, you go to update.kia.com and then go to notifications. This is where they list out the available updates. Once you've verified there that there is a new navigation map and software update available, you have to download it using their navigation updater software. To access it, you go to Navigation Updater Download at the top of the screen, and then click the appropriate button to download it to your Windows or Mac device, and just follow the install prompts. Once it's installed, you open the software and log in using your normal Kia owner's login information. Then pull up your vehicle and it will display the software system your vehicle uses. For the Kia EV6, it's the standard class Gen 5W navigation. Then you select the computer drive where you want to save the update. Typically, I download the update to my computer itself and transfer it to a USB drive. The last update shown here was about 31 gigabytes, which is actually too large for a 32 gigabyte USB drive due to formatting size. So you will likely need at least a 64 gigabyte USB drive for the new update. Once you select the drive, select the folder, and then it will start downloading. Once it's downloaded, you have the option to save to a portable storage device. Make sure you copy it to the root of the USB drive, not inside any folders. Then to update the vehicle, you turn on the car, plug in the USB drive, and typically it'll come up asking if you want to update the vehicle. If it doesn't come up automatically, you can manually get to the update screen by going to Setup, General, and clicking Update on the software update screen. Now, the update will take a little bit to run. I've seen people say it takes them anywhere from 30 minutes to a couple of hours. Personally, the last one took me about 45 minutes, so just be prepared. It has several steps it runs through to do the update. Just let it finish in its own time. But that's it. Once it's done, it will restart the software and you'll be good to go. So let me know if you have any questions on this process. I'll be keeping an eye on the Kia updates page, so as soon as I see that there is an update available, I'll let you guys know. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.